probably historically the biggest chunk of laggards we've had in a year, which isn't bad actually statistically. We're pretty good at showing up that tight. We're just gonna take care of that problem tomorrow, aren't we?
I think we said that a couple times ago.
Morning, y'all. Another Mitch Hedberg. We're on a roll.
Yeah.
This one's great. Rice is great if you're really hungry and want to eat 2,000 of something.
It's a good invitation, thank you.
Alright, sort report, Jeremiah.
Jeremiah, why do we sort and when do we sort?
We start at 6:58, once you hear the three bells in the morning, and we sort because it's our number one discipline, clear the floor to free up mental clarity and reduce clutter.
So we start with a broom, right?
No.
Start sweeping and shining?
We should shine at the end of the day before we all go home.
Hal, were you feeling pretty, we shine too, we 3S, that's all we're focused on, just so you know, primarily, and that leads to some. Often leads to improvement. Hal, you've been confused as hell since you got here.
What? Well, it's the sorting, you know, sometimes the cleaning, if it's the floor is dirty, you know, I feel like that's something that needs to be done.
So you have the sequence. Anyone, could someone else explain the sequence differently to Hal, please, other than you and you? Anybody else? Mark, why do we sort first?
You start with the floor and work your way up.
What's that?
You start with the floor, anything that doesn't belong there, pick it up, throw it away, put it in its right place, put it in the Corral de Oro.
Bruce, why is the question?
Why do we sort?
Why the sequence?
We sort first so that we have a unobstructed, clear area to work. No tools that you don't need, everything's where it's supposed to be so that when you do need it, you don't have to hunt for it, because if we were to do a line item on our billing, to our customers, they really, really don't want to see a line item that says $35 found screwdriver.
Aaron, what do you got, buddy?
I want it also clear so that we can actually see the problems that exist.
So there's a whole lot behind the history of this. It's not just Greg pulling it out of thin air. There's logic to it. It's just 40 years and still getting the concept. But does that make any sense to you now or not?
Yeah.
Because I've seen, how many of us have witnessed either ourselves or other people cleaning around something for days on end? Okay? You keep sweeping a rut around the thing that you're walking around, and the idea is clear the decks, liberate floor space, and any other horizontal space that's very sacred. Go ahead, back to you, headquarters.
Well, all right, very good. We're going to talk a little bit more about sorting, but first, what by when? Anybody want to share, or should I pick on somebody in the red? Bruce.
My what by when's on hold until we get our standards fine-tuned. So I kicked over and helped 2P out and was working on the electrical drawers in the customs area.
Thank you. Excellent. Thank you. Anybody's new here and doesn't have a good improvement to work on, Bruce, you might hand them some of the tasks of doing outlining once you've laid it out and done a Kaizen on how those drawers are going to be done. You've got to get the foam techniques. It could be someone new who doesn't really know a lot of the ropes. Could be executable if the precision's there.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
Easy to be engaged right out of the gate.
Yes, indeed. All right. Well, like I said, there's a lot of red up here, but we're going to get into some content. So please, tomorrow morning, I'd like to see a little less red. Update your boards if you have to. Talk to your area leads. Get some help. Let's get some of these big things done.
Yeah, I don't feel like this is a horrible burden. It's a tool we're trying to learn how to use. That's all. That's all it is. Thank you, Patrick.
Last time we finished up the review 8 through 14. We will be getting back into that tomorrow and the next day. And we've been talking about this test, and we want you guys not to get any test anxiety. And
I had test anxiety. I own the place. Yeah. Can't have that. So go ahead.
So it's gonna be. You know, we make things kindergarten simple around here. It's gonna be a kindergarten level test. All
but
right?
Not an insult.
No. What we want from you is engagement in the test, not memorize, spew, and forget.
These are sentences and
something
stuff.
Like
we'll start with words and lining them together. And what we're going to do is basically take a collection of the words that we've been studying for 4 years, the definitions, and have you guys just draw some line, like it felt so good when I was younger, right?
Draw the cat.
It's like, then you could go through and rate them in terms of meaning to you, 1 through 5 or whatever. You know, just say these ones really mean something to me, so that I feel like at least you have some inkling of what it's about. And start with that. Build on that foundation instead of jumping to this.
All right. Here we got a little customer video.
Hello to Pedestal Source and to Ben. Thank you for your video. Now you see that the pedestal you made houses our sculpture, and it has a place of distinction in our home. We love it. It's in a perfect corner where when everyone walks in, they'll see her displayed. Again, thank you, Pedestal Source. Thank you, Ben, from the Abaji's in California. Bye-bye.
Good job, Ben. Good
job. Hey. Thank you to the Abaji's.
Abaji's?
Mm-hmm. Very cool. Always need to see. All right, best Seinfeld impression. What's the deal with these colors? You guys will notice.
Thanks for taking the risk there, Patrick.
Hey, you're up next, Greg.
Yeah.
Hey, we got these colors, and it occurred to me that new people might not know what every color is. You find a tool. Where does this go? I don't know. It's color-coded. Doesn't give you any help without a key. So we're just going to go over these real quick. I've probably missed a couple, but these are the big ones. Yellow is?
Detailing.
Blue.
Paint
blue.
Blue. New guy. New guy. Shut up. Gray, tan. Tan gray.
So.
All right. Acrylics is purple. What about pink? All right. Orange? What about red? Okay. White. White is paint blue.
Sweet!
What about green?
Shipping.
And.
Custom. C2
Mega Custom. auxiliary glue up is one.
New to me. Forgot.
Yeah, this one is what used to be opposite of Customs 1. That's why the orange is there, and it's halfway in between Customs and detailing, thus the yellow.
Yeah.
So they tried to make sense, but it is kind of a oddball that's kind of been out of date. You know, used to be in the right place. Now it's just another drawer. It will be sorted. In the future, but if you find a yellow and orange tool, goes right there to the east of glue up.
Thank you, Patrick.
And blue and yellow.
No clue on blue.
It's the mobile detailing.
It's the mobile detailing kit. I commandeered those.
Cool.
And so those are the big ones. Did we miss any?
Yeah.
Who do we miss?
AP Pro. Southeast Assembly.
Oh yeah, that's a green gray, right?
Like
sage.
Sage
green.
Sage,
green.
Sage okay. Or mossy green.
And. I saw that CNC now has a color.
Metallic bronze.
Yeah, okay.
Cool.
Engineering's been using black.
Black.
Super depressing in there.
Okay.
I got a gallon of flat black we can
take you off. Take a hole off.
Yeah.
Excellent.
That's great. We actually knew something.
Yeah, yeah. I think everyone's pretty familiar, but occasionally I find somebody saying, hey, what color is this?
Yeah. Would Ryan agree with the sequence of colors?
There's color black.
Not at all.
Do we or can we have this posted
like
on the wall
more.
Or something?
Yeah,
for
it used to be.
I think that's
the let's just challenge. Print it.
Let's
print
complete it and yeah. Print it up.
Like thank you. Right. Wonderful. And so strong thank visual you. Control. How much is that part of our consciousness here as a company? Can I have a show of hands? I'm going to talk about strong visual control in my talk in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Thank you. And I'm going to take that and use it.
You just got strong visual that's, control.
Yeah, I did.
Thank you.
Cool, thank you.
All right.
1:30.
We got
chilling
picture it. Day. Hope y'all
yay.
Wearing your Sunday best.
Yep.
We're going to do a thank you card. Wendy, would you like to talk about it?
Well, yeah. When we do the thank you cards, I post all y'all's faces, which is great. It takes a lot of time, though, but I think a picture with our S&R environment. We're going to do can we do it just are you here tomorrow?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we can do it. I just wear your Xylem stuff. You don't have to.
So we do Xylem shirts if we have, which would
yeah,
be great.
Them.
Absolutely.
Yeah. And it's going to be a picture card. We're going to make the card ourselves with
we'll
all
of us. We'll make the
picture
and
you'll
do other things.
Yeah,
right?
And then, yeah. Anyway, and then I have
so,
the process.
Cool,
so.
56.
If you can hear me, okay. Maybe after the meeting, we'll take 15 seconds. I've got the camera set up. I just want to make sure it works, and then we'll
yeah.
Dial it in tomorrow.
Then
cool.
We'll yeah.
Dry
wear your Xylem.
Right on. I was thinking about woo. Getting a current photo anyhow. Thank you, Wendy.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Wendy, et cetera.
All right, thanks all. Last thoughts, anybody? Oh, I see a lot of almost
yeah, we're
going to
keep it
up.
Simple.
Yep. All right.
And thank you.
Gratitudes.
Thanks, Bruce.
Mm-hmm. I want to shout out Bruce for jumping across three people to do gratitudes.
There you go. And often.
Every time, Bruce, I come out here, I'm like, hey, how can I help you? You're just always really willing to help, really appreciate that. So write yourself up, buddy.
Yeah.
Every manager, it hardly shows.
On the outside.
On the outside.
I want to shout out John for all the Xylem values, especially respect and authenticity. Thank you.
On a second.
Second, third.
Yeah.
I shot Dave out for risking his life going up to put the up thing I delegated.
Yeah.
He didn't die. Nobody died.
Yay. Yay.
So it should be working now.
I shout out Alex for mind-blowing service. I broke something and then he just like fixed it without asking. Yep.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to shout out Alex for using the tools, the Gemba board. Because the only way you're going to tell if Alex is upset or not is if you look at the Gemba board and his name on it. Otherwise, you will never know. That's what I've learned.
All right, y'all. Well, pretty quick meeting. Thank you all
so
much.
Appreciate it.
Take it easy, but not before the-